applause for these brave souls.
Now, before we begin, I honestly would want a super huge round of applause to Mr. Hamright. So how you guys doing? Doing good? Alright. Well, allow me to introduce myself. I'm Aaron McHear. I am a senior here at Daniel Pearl Beckett High School. And actually, this is my first time performing or being in a Daniel Pearl World Magnet Day, World Music Day, sorry. So yeah, let's get this started. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Dr. and Mrs. Pearl, without further ado, welcome to the 7th annual Daniel Pearl World Music Day. Now, on a more serious note, what we're trying to promote to you today in our performance to you is peace, love, and harmony. And Daniel Pearl, a journalist of whom our school is named after, promoted and actually embodied all of these values. Of course, we're not alone in this endeavor of Daniel Pearl World Music Day. In fact, it's actually celebrated all around the world. So please feel free to celebrate with us by standing, clapping, and cheering and snapping.
This one, the day I met you. shining stars waiting with their light. For a time, I rest the race of the world and am free. monster, and monsters destroy.
You may have no peace or joy because you were born a revolting beast.
Well, at least their future is clear. No need to wonder about the love they'll never endure.
Or the dreams they'll never imagine.
Only the sins they'll supposedly partake in. And that's just a part of life.
But most monsters go through it without ever knowing why.
Or what. Yes, they're aware that they're monsters.
But no man has ever been able to tell them what that means.
The definition of a beast, or the reasons for their existence.
The answers to the questions,
which no one dares ask. What are they? And why do they exist?
They look like us, they talk like us, they act like us, have flesh and blood like us. Yet all their lives,
they get sent to convince them otherwise. They grow up to believe just that.
So, the question is, do monsters truly exist?
Is this myth we've conceived
really perceived as fact?
We call them monsters because they're different, when truly, there isn't even a difference.
Just the pride we somehow deserve above others
that causes us to fear the birth of these so-called monsters.
Friends shaking hands, saying how.
genius.
You have to strive for beauty or else you are ugly. And then you're disgusting. Support feminism and women's equal rights. Don't support it and you'll be rejected. Overly support it, and who do you think you are?
I have hate towards everyone, no matter who you are.
I only tend to love those who trample on others.
The ones who are trampled on are weak, useless.
The ones that break you are strong, victorious.
However, people who trample on others are weak inside, but the people with inner strength have no backbone to fight.
I am unfair.
I bring justice.
I bring destruction.
I build what has been destroyed.
I break innocence.
I protect the innocent.
I destroy their lives.
I give reasons for them to live.
I am contradictory.
I am blunt and straightforward.
You love me.
You hate me.
Regardless, life would change.
I am your world.
Thank you. merciless to anyone who refuses to do the same. We aren't supposed to name names or say what it is that tortures us. Just because a horrible thing happens doesn't mean we are to speak of it. The silence that follows our loudness leads into a crushing sadness that far too commonly causes our demise and madness. And to cure this, we smile, protecting our hidden hearts in an armor of denial, never shedding light upon the testimony of our trials, all the while thinking, something's wrong. We know it. Still, we continue to say nothing. But the only way to begin change is by speaking, for it's impossible to fight the silence.
The time will come when, with elation, you will greet yourself arriving at your own door, in your own mirror, and each will smile at the other's welcome and say, sit here, eat. You will love again the stranger who was yourself. Give wine, give bread, give back your heart to itself to the stranger who has loved you all your life, whom you ignored, for another who knows you. Take down the love letters from the bookshelves, the photographs, the desperate notes. Peel your own image from the mirror. Sit. Feast on your own life. One, two, three, four. I abhor all wars. Guns firing, machetes tearing. Open the flesh of the innocents. Children are screaming. Bottles are filled with blood, with tears still streaming. Where is the sanity? What drives people to erase an entire race? To all the killers, I say, look into the faces of all the families you've taken away. Can you see it? Inside, we all look the same way. For once, just stop the extremism and find a little realism. We are all one, two, three, four. I abhor all wars. Maybe it's the games that we play or the things that we say, but there seems to be a tolerance for violence in our everyday today. The men reveling in power turn to the people to say, it's a political matter. The cities, the villages, the families, the religion and races, evil taking lives by the masses, I learned from
Daniel Pearl, a man who had died by the brutality of the human capability, that we are each other's brothers. We are each other's keepers. So join hands with me and become a peace seeker. End the killing before it escalates, and then? No. Let me paint you a picture so it'll be a little more clear. This is a man who had a dream, who fought for the innocent screams and the streams of blood filling in the streets. All because hate resonates. He constructed a foundation so we could live a life of toleration. Now it is up to us to fulfill that obligation. Protesters quieted and turned to bystanders, one man trying to change life standards. It all feels me like a tidal wave. I've got to get it out. I've got to say, just save one, two, three, four. I declare an end to war.
Thank you. thank you everyone for coming and celebrating with us today. Can we give it a choir on the hand?
Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. Most of the students here at Daniel Pearl do not get to see this event because they are in classes and they are being instructed right now. So we were able to fit the ninth grade students in, and maybe that will become our tradition during the day that the ninth graders each will be able to see the show. We also have noted guests from Valley Alternative Magnet School. We have two classes of elementary students that come every year.
Martina Torres, my counselor and magnet coordinator.
always have wonderful words to share with all of you. I would really like to commend a young lady here today who showed tremendous composure, our dearest Rosie, who has been working so hard. Herself together. Her students come, her classmates comforted her, and she's back up on the risers and ready to celebrate the end of the show. So, on that note, I'm going to turn it over to Dr. and Mrs. Pearl for their remarks.
So much beer being made by so few musicians. Well, after his funeral, his sister was wondering, what are we going to do for his coming birthday? And the idea came up that we should celebrate it the way he wanted it to be celebrated. And that started the music day. And the same friends that played his wedding joined the Daniel Pearl Music Day. The first year we had 118 concerts around the world, and by today we have over 13,000 concerts that we played for one simple mission. And the mission is that a man is not a predator of another man, but a brother. A kindred spirit. And last week we went to Santa Monica to a concert like that run by the music teachers of Santa Monica. And one of the music teachers told me, I begin to understand why I'm drawn to Daniel Pearl Music Day. Yeah, we play music every day, but what draws me to Daniel Pearl Music Day is that it reminds us that music is not a performance, it's a statement. And that message I've seen today. You made a statement here for what Daniel stood for, and it's heartwarming for us to see if you continue Daniel's message. That a stranger is not a source for fear, but a source of curiosity. And I have an idea. Ed gave me an idea. To make this school unique, I've seen your commencement in spring, and I noticed that the Star Spangled Banner is being sang by one person as a performance. It should be sang by 400 visitors. So let's make your school unique. Next commandment, parents, uncles, cousins, everyone sings the song that everyone should know. It puts a burden on you to teach your parents the world of the music. We'll see you in your commencement. Thank you so much.
Mother of Daniel Pearl. prankster. He had a sense of humor. Very organized, except for his huge selection of music. He used to guide himself to visitors, ask me for any performance, and within 30 seconds, I'll pull the scene for it. So he could be organized. When I picked him up from Stanford after the first year of our driving, I said, Danny, you're not a kid anymore, you're an adult, and you'll have to be organized, you'll have to be neat. He said, what do you want me to say? And he left us at that. We got home, he opened his luggage, he spread it all over, he opened his typewriter. At that time, he had typewriters. And that was it. So one day, the housekeeper and me decided to organize his room. We took everything down from his desk, put the bedspread on his bed, and arranged it on his bed. And the desk was just as clean. He walked in. He said, I like it. I'm going to sleep on the desk tonight. So Danny did not confront, but made his point very clear with humor. And they said about him, there wouldn't be any violent discussion when Dan was around. And there was a new paper, a new magazine called Ventura that came out a few years ago. And I learned a story from there. One day, every day, the kids will gather around the school and they will have a very nice discussion before class. And one day it became a bit dusty and Danny couldn't control it. So he lay down on the floor and he acted like 2 years old and he screamed, why can't we get along? And everybody came with their backpack and piled it on him. And he achieved his objective. There was, humor and peace. The elephant story that I'd like to share with you. I was at a gym one time, and there was a musician, a female musician, pretty girl, young lady, whom he liked and he wanted to watch. So he, by accident, he kicked her guitar, her expensive guitar. And I'm going to read to you a little poem that he wrote. Put her cat in the blender. Well, I'm really so very sorry that I dented your fender. She looked at me like she was gonna kick my ribs in. I felt pretty dumb, like all but absent. I finally found a place I can stick my lips in. And then I had to go and scratch your Gibson. I am really sorry, because we were just starting. I was really looking forward to some heart-to-heart. But I can tell from the look on your face that you are hurting. And I really don't blame you, because I dropped you a Martin. who are really loving learning. You created this village to be as a model for all schools. And I hope that someone is going to take that idea and propagate it so we have some improvement in our schools, not just this one, not just the exceptional one. I love the students, I love the teachers, I love everyone. God bless you.
After the show in the school library, please join us. We have some refreshments. Dr. and Mrs. Pearl will be there. For the student performers and the international greeters, we won't tell anybody in the school district, but I have donuts for you all as well. So now, in order to exit orderly, maybe I can have Dr. and Mrs. Pearl and some of our front row noted guests go ahead and make their way out, and then we will begin dismissing the students. Thank you all so much for coming.
Thank you. whole process was really stressful with you barking up your backs and everything. But you guys looked so beautiful today. You guys all looked so good. You guys sounded like amazing, and I'm so proud of how hard it was for you. Like, you guys were so hard to make this happen, and it's honestly probably one of the best music days we've ever had. Can you guys just give yourselves a round of applause for having me?
So, I don't know exactly how to top that, but we have a surprise for Mr. Hambright right now. Like that, Mr. Hambright? But seriously, thank you guys so much. I know that we've been pain in the butts, and we all have. So thank you a lot, and love you guys. You guys are great.
And before anything, can we just get one more round of applause for Mr. Hambright, please? You know, when I told the crowd that I was really proud of working with you guys, I was serious. I'm really, you know, you guys stepped it up. We got this together. And what's cool is we get to do one more performance. Lots of times when we do this, we only have one, like, shot. This is nice. We get to do it again, have more fun Wednesday night. All right.
But can I hear who's ready for the winner show now?
And who's ready for karaoke?
All right, DJ, turn up the music just a little bit. Gentlemen, we have an announcement. If we can get your attention really quick. If we can get your attention really quick, we have a quick announcement.
So one more thing. We are, as most of you know, we're doing a holiday show December 7th. Okay? So here's the cool part. Because it's a short time. Hold on. Because it's a short turnaround, right? It's gonna be, you know, it's gonna be up to us to get this thing together fast. And how do we get that together fast? Well, we work together and we work on duets, trios, like, and get as many holiday songs from as many cultures as we can. So, what I want you to do is see me and write down your request of, I'd like to sing Jingle Bells, or whatever you wanna do, you know? I'd like to sing Jingle Bells with so-and-so and so-and-so on guitar, or whatever it is, okay? Is everyone cool with that?
Yeah.
All right. That's how we're going to get it together. It's going to be a lot similar to this, but we're going to be all, like, it's festive, you know, holiday gear, okay? All right. So see me and fill out an audition form for that. And I think that's it. A picture.
Thank you.
Guys, everyone out of the background.
The PearlNet News is a public forum for student expression. Students make all content decisions and opinions do not necessarily represent those of the Los Angeles Unified School District.
Directors of News, and I am Cesar Trujillo, the other news director. Today, we had a great performance from all the students who participated this year, and we hope you enjoyed the show. That concludes the performance for tonight, but for those of you that weren't able to watch it live and would like to, our school, Daniel Pearl, will be hosting another show on Wednesday night, November 2nd.
As parents and guests leave the NPR right now, performers are tidying up and our staff is getting ready for the Halloween dance tonight. We hope to see you there.
Don't forget, Red Ribbon Week is next week, in order to help teach everyone about the dangers of drugs and for everyone to stay away from them.
Students and staff, the Halloween costume contest is next Monday during lunch and will be held in the NPR, so make sure to dress up.
The Kadima's Dream Quartet will be here on November 2nd, where they'll be performing for the whole school, so please get excited for that.
Finally, we have in one instant, which is where a group is going to be talking about driving safety, and they'll be here on November 3rd talking to juniors and seniors in order to make sure we're all safe.
So Ahad and I will be signing off right now to help everyone clean up. We have some pre-recorded interviews with some of the performers today, and we're hoping to grab some more interviews with performers right now. We hope you enjoy the show, and we'll see you next week.
Till next time, Sharks.
Till next time, everyone.
What is World Music Day? What is World Music Day? World Music Day is an opportunity for students to come together to show their solidarity and their unity through music and spoken word, and to pay homage to Daniel Pearl and his legacy. We're a journalism school. He was a musician and a journalist. So we are putting together a show that includes both. Poetry, spoken word, and music to celebrate his life and to celebrate peace around the world.
Hi, my name is Jared Medrano, and I'm a sophomore at Daniel Pearl Magnet High School. Well, what I'm doing for World Music Day, I'm doing two solos. My first solo, it's a duet with one of the seniors, Anna.
Hi, I'm Jonas Acebes. For Daniel Pearl World Music Day, I am the stage manager for the whole set. So that basically means I am organizing everything, fixing little bits that Mr. Hambright doesn't really catch.
Jesse Cortez. I'm a tenor in the choir, so I'm the deeper voices of the choir.
Hi, I'm Erica Malari. I sing a soprano in the choir, and I'm also doing a duet with my friend Lisa Favela.
Hi, my name's Ashid Cabrera. I am part of the choir.
I'm preparing for World Music Day by just like rehearsing a lot and doing a lot of warm-ups and trying to get as much rehearsal time with my duet partner, Anna Monterosa, and trying to just get my duet like as perfect and as good as possible.
For Daniel Pearl World Music Day, I think we're preparing with like a lot of practice time and a lot of rehearsals. The lighting and sound should be good by now. The instruments are perfect, just the way they are.
Well, we practice at home, we practice in the class we have with Mr. Hambright, and we just work on it over and over again.
We are having rehearsals from Thursday until the day of, and Mr. Hambright's working his hardest. We're all putting in our effort and our time, and it's going good so far.
I'm about an 8 on the scale of 1 to 10 of how nervous I am, like an 8-ish, because obviously it's in front of the Pearls, and that's very important, and you don't want to mess up, especially the dedication to his son and everything, and how important it is to be professional in front of them. But I still have confidence in myself that I can do good, and I have confidence in my duet partner.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I think I'd be at a 6 right now, because it's not exactly the way I wanted it to be. It's not as perfect as I wanted it to be, but I think we could get there by the time